Do the popping sound. No. Yeah, that.
Hey guys, welcome to Nerd Locker Podcast, your entertainment podcast where we break down the latest in movies, television, video games, and more. My name's Adam.
I'm Oliver.
And today, not only are we wearing the same shirt, kind of, but we're also true classic, by the way. Go check them out. Link down below. We are talking about the penultimate episode of The Boys. We did The Acolyte. Now we're doing The Boys.
It's kind of wild. It's kind of a wild episode.
This episode just went. It kind of felt like it dragged on, and then it really got good.
I know. Really got good. You know what's it's crazy, because in the middle of the episode, we're like 7 minutes in, we're like, whoa, what are we doing?
Yeah, it felt dragged on for the first 30 minutes, and then like the last 30 minutes mm-hmm. of like just balls of the wall. So it opened up with what we thought was going to be like this all puppet show, which I'm glad it wasn't.
I'm very glad it wasn't. It's just the first 2 minutes.
But we get like a puppet show that Ryan's on, and they're talking all this bullshit. They're singing these songs that are very like pro-America, blah, blah, blah. And Ryan like cuts it. He's like, hey, like, nah, this is stupid. And he walks off. So as that happens,
he says he wants to do a 10-1.
Yeah. And then we come into, we have mother's milk with everyone at their like headquarters or whatever, mm-hmm. and Butcher shows up, and he shows up like Kessler in his mind, but he's kind of like admits to everyone that he took some mirrors doing the virus, blah, blah, blah. So we get more of that. And then it kind of like pushes like mother's milk over the edge to like go and get his ex-wife and daughter out. And I thought they were going with the comics guys, and they still might. I'm not entirely sure if they end the season this way. It's gonna be the saddest fucking thing ever. But so we get it to where like he's going to like let his ex-wife and daughter go off, and then he's like contemplating himself, Belize, like, right? Does he want to go or not? Yeah, to Belize and everything. And he gets intercepted. So guys, I'm gonna jump around like I have been for everything else. He gets intercepted by A-Train, who comes in and says, hey, you ain't getting out of this. Like, I put my life on the line, blah, blah. And we get to see A-Train, like, admit, like, he felt like a hero to that kid.
Yeah.
And everything. And A-Train is getting nuts. So then we get to a point where we are recapping, like, what happened to that anchor, Coleman, and how he was killed. And they claimed it was a brain aneurysm. And Ashley's still going off the deep end because she's like thinking like I killed him and blah, blah, blah. CEO. Yeah. And she's getting drunk at 11 a.m. when like Adrian comes in and says, hey, like we can't fuck this up. Like we got to keep this going, blah, blah, blah. And she's like, we need to run away. He's like, not right now, even though he kind of changes his mind later.
Mm-hmm.
And then we get some parts of the deep where he is talking with the octopus and obviously fucking Sage on the side.
Shit, what's her name?
And the octopus, Anessa, whatever. He is like screwing her over and everything. And meanwhile, while all this is happening, we also have the other weird thing going on, which is Firecracker kind of manipulating Homelander in different ways, and Homelander going kind of like he is already gone, dude. He is literally one more thing away from like completely breaking. I think that's what they're making all of season 5 about. I feel like we're about to see the turning point.
He's about to just not give a fuck.
Yeah, this is it. Like, he is holding so much restraint because he didn't kill Sage when he could have. But you also saw what he did to Web Weaver, which is another thing. So Firecracker brings Web Weaver in thinking he's the mole because she's dumb. She doesn't know what she's doing.
Right.
And fucking after some gross ass webs coming out of his butt because he was nervous. Homelander just rips him apart.
And Firecracker's like,
what the fuck, dude?
Like, astonished.
Yeah. So that's fucking nuts. And then meanwhile, so Butcher came back to, like I said, to the headquarters, and he broke Frenchie out of prison against his will. And they have to go, him and Kimiko go to take care of Samir. While there, he tries to tell Kimiko, like, hey, I needed to do my own time, but I missed you. And she's like, fuck you. I tried to visit you. You didn't let me in. And then she talks about what actually happened to her, where she lost her voice, which is when she killed this woman without making a sound, she decided never to talk again. Because that's just the way that the shining light was with them. Mm-hmm. Like, first person to make a sound loses and blah, blah, blah. So she just decided never to talk. So they kind of like feel each other in a different way, and they reconnect in their own way, which is kind of cool. And while they're doing this, Samir's like doing all this stuff and they're treating him so well. They're like, we're going to let him go and blah, blah, blah. But Samir does some fucked up shit because he's like, hey, come over here. And then he stabs Kimiko with that virus, trying to kill her. To which Frenchie has to go grab a fucking saw and cut off her fucking leg, which is nuts, dude.
And then, she doesn't pass out or anything.
Yeah. And then meanwhile, Sage is over here trying to like get Homelander to like, you know, be on her side and like understand her and everything. And he is slowly turning because of Firecracker. And then at the end of it, when we have the big confrontation, because throughout all this, one other side note I want to say, Huey and Starlight are going after the shapeshifter who is apparently talking to Sage. And that gets them like in this confrontation. The shapeshifter tries to attack them all, blah, blah, blah. And they end up getting away. So then later, after they're all like are minorly celebrating at a bar, you have MM, Butcher, and Starlight talking. And then Starlight says to Butcher about this previous fight they had, which I'm going to get into in a little bit, that he mentioned some things about Kessler. Which, again, I think it's like weird that no one else knew about Kessler. And I'm sure there's going to be some kind of like the rest of the boys digging up dirt on Butcher to figure this out. I think.
Can we go over, before you continue, the type of shapeshifter we're dealing with here?
Yeah, we're dealing with a shapeshifter that rips their basically touches someone, mimics them, and then rips their skin off to become them, which is reminiscent of Supernatural, which is what Eric Kripke has done before. But it's kind of funny how we have that like going on there. So like, at first when I watched it, I was like, that seemed very like one-off. And then I realized where they were getting to at the end of it.
We were thinking, what the fuck's going on?
So the big confrontation plus the twist at the end. Confrontation is Butcher and Starlight get back to the headquarters and they're confronted by the Deep and Noir. Mm-hmm. And we see a full-on brawl where like the Deep is like going at Starlight, blah, blah. Because prior to this, guys, the Deep comes home after fucking Sage and the octopus calls him out on it. He gets pissed off, breaks her tank, and then lets her die. Just closes the door and lets her die. After she is screaming for fucking what seems like 20 minutes, dude. Like, please help me stop.
That was crazy.
Please help me stop.
That was very Zombieland. Bill Murray, Zombieland.
In a way, yeah. It was more of like he could have saved her at any point. Yeah, he just never decided to.
Octopuses can last like a pretty decent time out of water.
Yeah, we can see. But so with that in mind, he's now on this like killing mission, tells Homelander, I'll kill anyone. So Homelander sends him and the Noir to go kill Butcher and Starlight, which doesn't turn out so well for them because Noir shows off that he is kind of invulnerable, but also like he can fly and everything.
Yeah,
and
what the fuck was that?
Yeah, he already said multiple times that he could fly.
Damn.
And so we have this issue of like him being a little more OP, but they still end
is
up
it over like a jetpack or is it him?
No, it's him. Oh, he can fly. Damn. So we have all this stuff and then like MM comes in with A-Train and they save their ass, like beating the hell out of Deep, and A-Train's like, I always fucking hated your ass anyway, so like just start wailing on them and blah, blah, blah. And then Starlight like goes at Deep and like uses the fucking weight but doesn't kill him, which I'm very surprised.
I know.
It's just not in her to kill right now, even with like Firecracker. So we have this big confrontation, and then at the end of this all, we have... they all celebrate at the bar, blah, blah, blah. And then this one fan comes up and takes a picture with Starlight, and everything seems fine. We go on. Then at the end of this, halfway through the episode, we realize that Huey didn't throw away the Starlight costume because Starlight calls her mom. Her mom kind of like ridicules her in a fucked up way of like, you shouldn't have gotten an abortion, blah, blah, blah. And we find out that Huey kept the costume. He ends up throwing it out, but then it seems that Starlight comes and brings it out of the trash and uses it to have sex with Huey. And then we find out that it wasn't Starlight. It
was not Starlight.
It was the shapeshifter who has taken Starlight because she was the one that was the one that took a picture with Starlight, kidnapped her, swapped out with her, and has had relationships.
At the bar, by the way.
Yeah. Has relationships with Huey, which is really weird, but we'll see where that goes. So this is all, and then gets Huey's like laptop out of the safe that has all of Newman's information. So we'll see where this goes.
So like the, and that also means that confirms that like whatever memory the shapeshifter takes is the memories, but of
it also tells person. Me this too though, like maybe at the moment, like as of right now when she's taking the laptop, it's like okay, or it, because we don't know who they are taking the laptop, they're going on what Sage has said, which is basically like the boys are the enemy. But now that Sage has been fired from the boys, which is another thing I didn't get into, but like instead of killing her, Homelander just fires her. Maybe now she'll be like, wait, maybe let's not use it for what we're going to do. Like, it might get changed
maybe
last minute. Could be. Because of this all. So we'll end up seeing. But yeah, I mean, overall, what do you rate this episode?
What do you rate the episode? It's a lot that happened, you know?
That was a really intense fight between, like,
Noir. It was a slow start.
We got some comedic
relief there.
Yeah, I'm going to say there was still a little bit of gross. So, like, seven.
Seven?
I'm going to say seven. That's because we got to see Butcher say cunt a lot of times.
Yeah. I mean, I love the word gun. I'm going to say, shit, fucking cunt. I'm going to say like eight.
Eight? Okay.
Yeah. Butcher needs to be more of a presence here.
Yeah. I think in season five, he will be. There's a lot of rumor that he's going to be one of the Wolverine variants in Deadpool.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that'd be fucking awesome.
That would be great.
Dude, he can call cunts all over the place.
Right? But before we get into our extra little bit of segment, here is a word from our sponsor. Let's talk about data breaches. You know how creepy it is to get ads that are like way targeted?
It's absurd. I literally got a text the other day and it just said, "Hello, Oliver. How are you today?" I'm like, I don't know you. How do you know my name? What's happening?
I sometimes respond and I'm like, who is this? And they're like, nah.
They're like,
they don't respond back at all. Yeah. I also get like weird Instagram ads, things like that. It's so weird. And the thing is, like, these data brokers, they have your full name, your address, your email, and your health records. And they sell it all for like a buck, dude. Quick dollar.
Honestly, so that's why I started using Aura. It's like a superhero for your privacy. It's great. It's amazing. It scans the dark web for your information that's being sold, and then bam, automatically opts you out of those shady websites so you don't get those really creepy messages that I definitely don't like. You get less spam, and that's just the beginning. Like, having your info out there makes you a target for hackers who could also just crack into your social media, bank accounts, and the whole nine.
Really? Huh. Well, you know, the thing is with Aura, they go above and beyond just privacy, though. They also have VPNs, they also have antivirus, and they have a password manager, like, you know, someone that doesn't forget.
What?
They even have parental controls and identity theft insurance. It's all pretty good. And not only that, it just keeps it simple instead of all those different apps that you have to download and stuff like that.
It's really, really annoying. But look, I know you might already have some of these figures covered, but think of it like this. Aura has 24/7 security. That's like the whole week and then some hours. That's crazy. That's like all the hours.
Yeah, that's all the hours.
It's basically 24/7 security guard working tirelessly in the background so you can browse, game, and stream with a peace of mind.
It's honestly one of the best services, guys, especially for different things. Instead of all the malware protection, you get your own VPN service, all that stuff in one.
You get VPN?
And VPN, yeah. Oh, wow. So honestly, with all that, you can get it's all for an affordable price too. But if you guys want to try it out, you guys can go to aura.com/nerdlocker and you guys can get a 2-week free trial to try it out and see exactly how it is. It's going to change everything for you guys. It was crazy how much of my stuff was on the dark web.
Less spam.
It's so much on the dark web, guys. They have all the information that you can even think of. Like, just do yourself a favor, make your online life a lot easier with aura.com/nerdlocker. Down below, get a 2-week free trial.
2-week free trial, huh?
Yep. I like 14 days.
14 whole. Yeah, you got 14 fingers over there?
10 and 4. 14.
That's not 4. You just did this.
Pick number 3, my lord. And we're back.
European pools.
I'm kidding. Back to this. All right, guys. So this little extra bit of segment is something that has already been out for a minute now. But we finally watched the first episode because one of our friends told us to. We watched Has-Been Hotel.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, watched the first episode of that, guys. So if you've seen it, really good. That first episode was
fucking
awesome.
Dope, dude.
So, guys, it has Alex Brightman and Stephanie Beatrice. If you know Stephanie Beatrice, she's from Brooklyn Nine-Nine. Alex Brightman played Beetlejuice in the original Beetlejuice. It was
so musical.
Just, like, so vulgar, so great. Like, so many times you have to just pause and, like, what the fuck
just
is going
laugh.
On?
Yeah. Just laugh.
It was a really good time. So, if you guys haven't seen it, please watch it. We'll probably watch more of it in the future. We might talk about it in a little bit, but it's... We don't know if it's getting season 2, so we'll see.
No, we know we're late.
We're very late.
We're very late. But we'll we watch it after the boys, so just bear with us.
And then the other thing that I do want to bring up is we are also currently still catching up with My Hero. At least Oliver is. I'm all caught up on sub.
Caught up on dubbed, motherfucker.
No, he's not. He has one episode left.
I'm one episode behind, motherfucker.
But guys, also that's another thing. Like, as I'm looking at it, these seasons have been historically 25 episodes. And we're only in episode 7 or 8. Which means we're getting... I've said a lot of times I thought season 8 was going to be last. Depending on how quickly they get through this, this could be the last season.
Oh, yeah?
Depending on how fast they get through this battle, unless they make season 8 like a half season. To like do their like little epilogue thing that's happening in the manga. But I'm like, dude, they're... really getting close.
Oh shit.
Really getting close.
So the manga's ended.
Almost. They have four chapters left of the manga. How August 5th it ends.
August 5th. Okay.
Yeah.
So it's a chapter per week?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So August 5th it ends. I'm gonna assume season 7 because it's not even halfway through the first season or through the 7th season. Like, and they've already started the final battle, and there's so many other things. Like, there's a lot that happens. I can either see them ending the full of season 7 with like the big like oh my god moment that mm-hmm. like kind of happens in the battle, which would be like towards the climax, okay. or ending the first half of season 7 with gotcha. This. It really just depends on what the next couple of episodes are. I don't know.
Let me ask you something.
Unless they do like filler.
So like are a huge My Hero fan. Yes. I know that. How do you feel about it ending? I know a lot of people tend to like not even finish TV shows for some reason because they don't want it to end, so they don't watch the end.
I think with this one, as of right now, where they're going, I'm like back and forth because it's more of like I kind of wanted more out of the final battle, but this epilogue is giving me the stuff I needed. Like, I'm not going to spoil anything. The last chapter changed a lot and brought back a lot of plot lines that I kind of thought they were gonna like
just do to the wayside. Off. Okay,
and they bring them back, and I'm like, that's a little like not only just surprising, but more like, dude, I even forgot about that. So it's like they're really wrapping up in the last couple of chapters everything that we saw. Like,
that's kind
of
cool.
Very quickly, but also very impactful to like the future of what everything is going to be in this universe. Because I kind of like thought, not gonna lie, when I was watching this show. A couple years ago, you asked me, I would have bet you money Deku's going to die at the end. Bet you money. Like, greatest hero of all time, self-sacrifice. That's not exactly how it goes down. Like, there's a sacrifice, but in a different way. And I'm like, okay. But, like, I'm still just curious to how much further. Also, the only thing I will say, only a minor spoiler of something that hasn't happened yet. They still haven't really acknowledged Deku and Ochaku. And that's really been pissing me off because I'm like, they keep setting this like seeds for it. I'm like, don't leave that off like you did with like, what was it in Yu-Gi-Oh, Yugi and like Taya.
Yeah.
Like where like.
Yo, Yugi and Taya can fuck.
Like it's there, but it's not. They never really push it. That was
really annoying.
Because even when they did Dark Side of Dimensions for Yu-Gi-Oh, which was like the true ending of Yu-Gi-Oh, where like Kaiba really wants to fight the Pharaoh again. So he goes and finds the Millennium Puzzle, recreates it, forces it on Yugi. Says bring a temp back, and Yugi's like, he's fucking gone, bro. So then this other shadow thing like tries to like duel Yugi, almost beats him. Yugi's about to faint, and then the Pharaoh comes out of fucking nowhere, says, I'm back one more time, and then beats this guy, and then everything seems all good, and then Taya goes off to New York. And
like, right, I remember that.
And then that's it. Like Taya's gone. That was it. And then she's wrestling there. And then the stupidest post-credit scene in the entire world, guys. If you haven't seen Yu-Gi-Oh! Or don't want to get spoiled by Dark Side of Dimensions, click away now.
Skip forward.
At the end of Dark Side of Dimensions, the last fucking scene of what is Yu-Gi-Oh! Proper is Kaiba finally finds a technology to transport his consciousness into the afterlife to fight a Tem in the afterlife in Egypt, where like Tem just sees him and just like smiles when Kaiba's just there full duel disc, like ready to fucking fight him.
Dude,
like,
they have duel disc back then.
Not even back then. He has a duel disc and Tem's just gonna fucking use tablets. But like, bro, this guy can't let this go, man.
That's weird.
Like, dude, let it go. Just
calm down.
You're not the best.
Take it easy, it's okay, Kaiba.
Like, to not be the best.
Kaiba, be Kiba.
You
I don't know.
You forced him to... You said I... In the first fucking season, either you beat me and I kill myself.
Or kill you yourself.
Don't beat me.
Fucking do it.
And yet Yugi's like, nah, he's can't like, let you. Pfft. So, I don't know.
But how do you think you will feel when My Hero Academia ends is my original question. Are you going to hop onto like a different anime that's like super popular? I know Jujutsu Kaisen is very popular now. I've debated on watching
it. I don't think I'm going to jump on another anime. I might finish off Demon Slayer. I kind of stopped for a little second. God, I love Demon Slayer. I might go back into Demon Slayer and try out some other animes. I think with My Hero, I have a funny feeling. I don't think I will like be as invested in the anime, but I have they had a spinoff in the manga called My Hero Vigilantes, which kind of had like
street, in street a manga.
Level. Yeah, it's like street level people that were like kind of like also idol. There's another guy that kind of idolized All Might, but same like, writer. None of them really have good quirks.
Is the same writer?
No, the same writer came the concept, but different writers have taken.
I see.
So it's okay. I don't know if they definitely in the manga have mentioned those characters like in different ways towards the end. So like they're definitely acknowledging it's canon in the manga. So they might do the same thing in the anime. That's but like, cool. I wonder if they will make an anime of that or like a one-off series of it because it did go on for a while. It ended really quickly, but it still had like at least like of the American mangas, like I think 20. So it had a good amount of them.
Did you not like the anime I showed you? The the Firefire Squad one.
I did.
Really good, like sound.
Mm-hmm. I did, but that was just a one-off kind of thing. Like it just.
I know we just kind of watched.
When it comes to like those one-offs, like that was a while back.
I loved it so much.
But yeah, I don't know. I might jump on something else. I'm not entirely sure as of yet. I definitely will finish off Demon Slayer and see where it goes from there. But yeah.
I'm just trying to see if I can find. Fire Force.
Fire Force. Okay. Well, other than that, where can they find you?
You can find me on Fire Force. Just kidding. I'm lying. You can find me on the Sphere 21 on any social media platform except for TikTok. I'm Oliver Khan VA. But as my other account, I am the Sphere 765. So if you want to, I don't know, hang out, sure.
Or send him a DM, slide in his DMs.
You can slide in there. I won't respond. But.
And you can find me at AOMRE Photography. You can find the studio at Archangel Studios Official. And you can find this podcast at Nerd Locker Podcast, wherever you get them on Apple and Spotify.
Exactly.
And slide into our DMs.
What is that? What is that? Be a bird? I can't even do it.
Ha.
I need more. Bitch. Oh, no. Do that popping sound.
Don't be a fucking...
We'll be right back.